in y'all. Whoa. Look out.
What is it good for?
Absolutely.
Now
listen to me. Oh, whoa. I despise. Cause it means destruction of innocent lives. War means tears to thousands of mothers.
I believe that what we're doing is the best way to communicate with the normal man of the street, really. We've given up on governments, we've given up on politics so far.
With all of the art being visual, I think it allows people to have their own interpretations, and that will help to get people talk about peace, you know, because it's something that everyone's got an opinion of and there's no right or wrong.
My figurative forms in the relation with this exhibition is about the sacred geometry, and we will the one massive creation bomb.
I'm Secretary General of International Alert. We're an independent London-based international peacebuilding organization. Peacebuilding is about starting from a piece of paper and a signature on it, and transforming peace from being a matter of a signature into part of the daily reality of the lives of many, many people. For us, it's peaceful when people can pursue their conflicts and their disputes without harming each other. We think that dispute, argument, and actual conflict can be very important and very valuable. The question is, can you manage it so that it will happen without violence? For International Alert, the problem isn't conflict, the problem is violence. As an international organization based in London, we've felt that we needed more visibility, more support, more awareness from people here. So this is the Talking Peace Festival. It's been going on for about 4 weeks now. They involve a number of different activities, including artistic activities. And I honestly can only say that the way in which we got these artworks is that we asked artists if they would like to paint something to show, to express their feeling about peace.
Some artists, like Yoko Ono, for example, donated a piece of art to us, while others actually created it live as part of our campaign and as part of the Talking Peace Festival. So some of them painted live inside Old Street Tube Station, where for the first week of the festival we had a peace booth where artists were interpreting what peace meant to them, and at the same time passers-by could also tell us what peace meant to them by taking pictures and writing messages on clipboards and etc. And others actually created artwork again on the street. So it was really a different variety of ways, and others created it in their studios and then sent it to us.
What we're trying to do here is talk to the normal people, people like you and I, those guys on the street. This thing is happening, those people are dying, and that's the only way we can communicate to. We really cannot trust the media here because, again, the media always have their own agendas.
I've got it on a street art poster to kind of reflect the propaganda that often happens in war-torn countries. And what I wanted to do was to create something that would inspire people to talk about peace and why we need to get thinking more about that. As opposed to always looking at the problem, we need to try and think more about a solution.
When you talk to a normal person, they actually don't know what's going on in Syria. Lots of people think it's a civil war. Nobody knows it's a revolution, for example. Nobody knows about those people dying. Nobody knows about the child in the photo. The graffiti is inspired by a photograph of a small child who lost her home. The photo shows her the destroyed home in the background and her very cute face. Nobody knows about them. All they hear is Syria, more people dying, and next to the next news.
I've got a child soldier that's holding a gun whilst wearing fairy wings. So it's a very kind of ironic image. It's about the loss of innocence.
And of course, as you look around the world, you see a lot of pain and misery and war, not least in the Middle East. But actually, peace is the big unwritten good news story of the last 25 years. There are about half as many wars going on now as there were 20 years ago. And part of that is because organizations and people, governments and independent groups like International Alert have learned how to contribute to building peace.
At the end of the day, we've tried everything else. We've tried politics, we've tried human rights, we've tried United Nations, we've tried all sorts of council. My last resort, our last resort is people like us. I can give you examples, really. I mean, now, to this date, what do you know about Syria in the past few weeks, in the past few months? Nothing at all, absolutely nothing. All the focus of the world is on the Islamic State's atrocities in Iraq and northern Syria.
To end this festival, we'll have a final party and auction where all of this amazing artwork will be up for sale. So to generate more awareness about the importance of art and peace.
Positive young lions and the king of fire. Can't call couple dog. Yo, I want to them. The youth them say peace. From the north to the south and to the west and to the east. Unity, strength, me say yeah, that we are bridge. Hatred and violence get trampled on the feet. All right again, so the youth them say peace. From the north to the south and to the west and to the east. Hatred and violence get trampled on the feet. Unity, strength, and that the youth them a preach. Well, bigger judgment than one and yet. Babylon me say they want to divide us. From a hatred them a deal with, tell them wise up. Unity strength.
This artwork is called Colors of the Globe and it's by Yoko Ono. It's an interactive piece of art that encourages the audience to get stuck in. The idea is really to ask the public to imagine what peace means to them and to draw it. So, in a way, what colour is peace? What colour is the world? So it's up to the audience to colour it in. This is Wolf and Tank by Victor Ash. And what it represents is a message of peace. So for him, the idea of having the wolf is what basically survives a war. But the fact that there is a wolf which is alive on top of a tank, it's a message of hope and of almost rebellion against war. This is Untitled by Syrian artist Tarek Tuma. It's a message of hope. For him, art is a powerful tool for peace. And in the midst of the destruction and the horrors happening in Syria, he uses art to portray a hopeful message for Syria's future. This is The Sun Sets on All of Us by street artist 616. And the idea behind this artwork is really that people, at the end of the day, they're the same, they're people.
What?